please welcome Kevin Paca from Tame Impala. Kevin, great to see you. You're back at home.
Yeah.
Just wanted to clear something up for the uninitiated. Well, Tame Impala is your band.
Uh-huh.
You are Tame Impala. It is you.
Sure. Yeah, it's confusing, I know.
It can be.
Well, it's basically like I just record the music by myself, like kind of multi-track it, you know, and then to play it live, I get my friends in the band, basically.
But it's all you, all your magic.
It's all me, yeah, 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 with the magic of multi-tracking.
But this caused a bit of a problem, didn't it, with the first EP? You put it all together yourself, but then yeah. You're a bit sheepish about telling the record company that it was all you.
Yeah, I basically told them it was a band, and like I just pretended it was a band because I didn't think they'd be interested if it was.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think like around then, like solo producers weren't really a thing. It was more like kind of like rock bands were the thing. So I was like, oh yeah, we're a rock band, and we signed the contract and everything. So like, all of us.
You know. Anything they didn't like, you just blame it on the imaginary guitarman.
Exactly.
Yeah, Matt bunged it.
Exactly.
Mate.
It was easy to hide, you know, hide all the yeah.
There's a question I've been wanting to ask for a very long time. Tame Impala, the name, where does it come from? Because I've worked with a lot of Impalas and I'm yet to meet a tame one.
Interesting. Of course, you're a vet.
Yeah.
Thank goodness you're a vet.
Sorry, just putting two and two together. I just thought of it.
Did you?
Honestly, yeah, I was sitting at home on the couch at our share house, and yeah.
You
I mean, like, I've come up with stories to like explain how I thought of it, but they're all just like stories I came up with to say something. So the honest truth is, there's no story.
It just
sounded cool.
Cool story.
Yeah. Cool story.
You're finally getting to play your Slow Rush shows here in Australia. These were originally scheduled for 2020.
Yeah.
Does that make it even more special?
Of course, yeah, yeah. I mean, like, touring Australia for me is special already. It's like, it's where we first started touring. We used to do it just all the time. Australia was the only thing we did. So, like, over the years, less and less we've got to tour Australia, so it's just like such a special thing for me to just seeing all the airports, you know, like it sounds really like, you know, really weird, but like, you know, just being at Brisbane Airport, I'm like, oh, I miss this place. You know?
That's an Australian news agency. That is
exactly.
Like,
oh, we know we're all, yeah, we know the Hungry Jacks is and stuff like that.
We saw some visuals of your live show there. It is so visually spectacular. It actually comes with its own health warning, right?
I think we have a warning on the tickets and it's like up around the venues and stuff. I think like most shows have that.
Hmm.
I posted a little thing on Instagram the other day too. I don't know. I kind of just felt like saying, hey, just remember, yeah. You know, got some powerful moments
yeah.
in the set. So, you know, I don't know. I just kind of felt like it was the right thing to do.
It is the right thing to do because, our own Tara Rushton went to a gig of yours about 10 years ago
mm-hmm.
and slipped in the bathrooms, hit a chin and saw the rest of the gig, am I right, with an ice pack pressed
yes.
to your face?
It was over 10 years ago, so it would have been one of your first gigs and I did slip over in the bathroom and then I had to approach the bar and say, do you have something for my chin? And they gave me an ice pack, so I watched your phenomenal show like this
wow.
for the whole night. I yeah. wish they would have tied it around my head, that probably would have been a bit better.
Uh-huh. Wow,
some long-lasting impressions. I know. I mean, beat
good.
That.
Yeah, yeah. Well,
your music had a profound effect on me.
Yeah, yeah. You could enjoy it through the pain.
Yeah.
Ironically, she looked like a Tame Impala. Like she was just kind of out a bit like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
You've had a lot of life changes since these shows were meant to kick off. Congratulations on the birth of baby Peach.
Thank you.
Has becoming a parent curbed your rock star lifestyle at all?
Oh.
So cute.
Oh, there she is. There. That's yeah. I think curbed is the wrong word. It's changed it a lot. It's like just a whole new element to being away from home, and like having her on tour is interesting too. It's fun, you know. It's like I'm the rock star on tour until she comes on tour, and then she's the rock star. You know, it's like I'm just like part of the support crew for her tour.
I really want to know, as a young dad myself. And you're such a great muso, but has your child stuffed up your Spotify playlist? Because
yes,
I know for me, you know, mates come around, they're like, oh, we'll crank out your Spotify playlist. I'm like, please don't. It'll just be Bluey on repeat.
Yeah. Yeah, there's definitely a bit of Wiggles in there, for sure.
Talking about the Wiggles won Triple J's Hottest 100 with a cover of your song. Are you even a little bit slightly annoyed that
that they won it and you didn't?
Not at all. No, that wasn't the feeling. I mean, the feeling was just, it was surreal. It was bizarre. You know, like, weirdly, I was at a birthday lunch, like my birthday lunch, when they read out that Wiggles were number one. Everyone was sort of like, you know, applauding and stuff. It was bizarre, but yeah, it's obviously like good on them, you know, it's amazing.
Congrats Wiggles and Tame Impala for all the info on the remaining Tame Impala shows. Please head to our website. Kevin Parker, thank you for being on the project.